Within 2 weeks, he crossed into the province of Hither Spain, accompanied by his sons, the youngest, Titus, riding alongside him, mounted on a small white cob. Claudia, with the baggage train between the two auxiliary legions, comfortable in a litter, surrounded by her husband's personal bodyguard. Quintus, his eldest son, a year older than Claudia, rode ahead with Nepos, the cavalry legate, in command of the advance guard. Within a week, they would be in the provincial capital of Saguntum, ready to begin the task of defeating Brennos. At that moment, everything in his life seemed perfect, his happiness unassailable. Aulus, trusting his horse not to stumble or leave the roadway, closed his eyes tightly as less pleasant memories surfaced, recollections of a truth he had ignored. A slave had stood behind him in his war chariot as, face painted red, dressed in the deep purple toga of a victorious general, he rode down the Via Triumphalis, responding to the cheers of the crowd gathered to celebrate his Macedonian victories. The man was there to remind him, by whispering in his ear, he needed to beware of the sin of hubris. The gods would bring low any man who dared to forget he was a mere mortal, for they would not be mocked. Doing battle with barbarians was very different from engaging the disciplined army of a state like Macedonia. Formal combat, in which he would confront the entire enemy host, was not something Aulus expected, despite their numerical superiority. His informants confirmed the Celtiberians at his approach had withdrawn from the coastal plain and taken to the hills. This underlined his belief it would be a war of ambush and raid. He had set himself for a difficult task, with his legions broken up, operating in centuries and cohorts, trying to destroy the means by which the rebels sustained themselves. They would need to be ruthless and cruel, burning villages and destroying pasture and crops, taking hostages and enslaving women and children if the insurrection was to be brought under control. He, in turn, would need to be tough to prevent his troops from descending into a rabble, if required, killing some to maintain discipline.